everyone, I'm José María Cañizares, Ruiz-Funes, and today I'm going to explain my school organization and school diversity exam. Let's go!
For the first tag, I have selected the Save El Sifón, that is in Molina de Segura and provides education to students in their early years of schooling. It aims to provide a comprehensive learning experience that promotes academic, social and emotional development. The El Sifón may have a team of dedicated and qualified teachers who strive to create a supportive and stimulating learning environment for their students. They are likely responsible for planning and delivering lessons, assessing students' progress, and providing individualized support when needed. I told you the school is located in Molina de Segura, which is a city located in the region of Murcia. Its population consists of a diverse community of people. The residents of Molina de Segura came from various backgrounds, including Spanish nationals as well as individuals from other countries. The local population engaged in a wide range of occupations and industries, reflecting the diversity of the local economy. People in Molina de Segura work in sectors such as agriculture, manufacturing, service, education, healthcare, and administration.
Oh, yes, sorry, I didn't see you. You come because a group of students the other day asked me to add Islam to the school. Yes, that's true. Do you want also to be included in the Islam religion? Okay. As you can see, another student asked me to include Islam religion. That's probably because there are a lot of Muslim people here. And I think that it would be a great idea to include Islam in the school. I think we are going to have some measures and include it in the school.
For doing these measures, I have to take into account the Article 16 of the Spanish Constitution, the Article 27.3, and the Article 10 of the Commission of the 26, 1992. Now I'm going to tell you the measures I will take in my school as a principal. The first one would be to allow every person that wants to wear their own costume from their country, that include the hijab for Muslim women, but also for Bahá'ís people or Indian ones. The second one would be a meeting to the parents of the incorporation of this subject that wouldn't be compulsory for all students and would be only for those students who want to be in that class. Here they have the opportunity to change their songs to that new subject. If the ratio of pupils who want to do this subject is higher than the minimum, we can continue and create that class.
The third one would be asking the consejería if they can send us a Muslim teacher and create a subject about Islam religion, while the other students are taught Catholic religion. Also, I will adapt the menus in the school canteen if they contain any nourishment that is not allowed in their diet. For example, Islam people can't eat pork, or Catholic people aren't able to eat pork in Lent. Another measure I will take would be doing holiday, one of the most important days of the Islam community, as it happens nowadays with the 1st of November in Catholic religion. I will also reject every kind of solicitude from any cultural or religious statement to the school, as it can create discrimination to those who don't go to that meeting because of their convictions to prevent bullying inside the classes. A great idea also would be doing some meetings with social educator in the last step of primary education, because it is when some female students start using the hijab, telling the pupils what it means and why they decide to use it. Also, I will eliminate all kind of symbols in the classroom or outside the classroom that can show any kind of religious term inside the school. Students don't have to feel they are not in a space that doesn't represent or feel them comfortable. I will also do some meeting with the students of the same class in the playground the last day of school, where they show what they have done along the whole year in their subject to show them to the rest of the students. Now, the last one is a bit more controversial, but I think that ordering the PE teacher to respect the decision of Muslim women not to do physical education if they are able to do it, because in some cases, women have to take off their hijab for doing that activity, for example, swimming, and they aren't allowed because of their conviction. The teacher should do another activity to them or just create a new activity for all of them. Now, using the context of the previous activity where we said that we are working with Save El Sifón from Molina Segura, I'm going to use five methods to make sure coexistence will exist in the group. First one, the teacher designs a unit project where there are different modules. These modules will have some active problems that there are in the society nowadays, for example, racism, bullying, or economic discrimination. The student will have the opportunity to select their own project, but they should do a presentation analyzing that situation. All the material will be given by the teacher the day he sends it to the students. The first day, the teacher will ask the students to make the coexistence rules inside the class. This rule will be done by the students, and they will also decide which punishment they are going to have if they don't follow those rules. Students here have the opportunity to voice their opinion, make suggestions, and participate in group discussion for consensus or various matters. Another day, the teacher will mix the students in some groups. He decides from different ethnics or intelligence abilities to check if the students are able to coexist with different people from their usual surroundings. Another day, the teacher will give the students different material from different cultures. While the students are drawing, painting, or searching for information about that culture, they learn that more people exist in the world and they are not all like them. During this time, the teacher organizes group activities and could also help if there is any conflict while doing the rules. And finally, the last method the teacher can use to ensure coexistence in class is that one day each student brings any personal amulet from their culture or religion and shows it to the rest of the students. The student will make groups attending and the teacher won't explain anything. Only a student will tell the rest of their mates how their culture is, and they, like this way, they are going to respect the other's one. Now I'm in a situation who presents special needs related to intellectual disabilities. What I should do? What I will use to attend to intellectual disabilities would be mixing students with high intelligence with others who have it lower. Here there will be an example. Okay, first of all, the first day I will do an evaluation to the whole group to see if they are more or less at the same level for doing an activity or there are any deficiencies in some students. How will I check it? I will first make a round of open questions to the class and later will get them a paper with some questions which they will have to answer. Secondly, once I have checked what the student said in the survey who brought me, in the afternoon I will think on how to divide the groups for next class while they are doing an activity related to what was said the day before in class. Finally, the next day in class, the student will divide the class into two groups that will be set by the teacher while they are entering the class to start doing the activity in groups with members from all kinds of the results from the exam. When the class finishes, each group will present their activity and will say what they have done each member of the group. In this way, a student will see that everyone is able to do everything he wants and there are no deficiencies between students.
In my opinion, I think I have done a great job in this video, so I believe that my score will be placed between a B- and a B+ for the exam. All documents and images of the world have been referenced and I have explained correctly all terms I have learned along this course in the subject. One question, I think that my answer would be just so basic, but I didn't know what leadership styles were. So learning that there are 6 or 7 different leadership styles, it is very important for me. Each one is different from the other one. And I think that's the most important thing I have learned. Something I couldn't imagine before is the hard work that a director has to do in a school, because you know that the director usually does 1 or 2 classes, but there are also a lot of work behind their place that you didn't know. And now that I have done the school organization, this course, I know that he have to make a leadership style and attend to all petitions the students do. One thing I have learned in university is that every student must work with other students to respect the other space and to know what they have to do and know that there are people with different abilities that they have. Part will answer the importance of this subject, because this year I have done a volunteer along the whole year and I had to take different works for the different students because they were different, so it's important to know about diversity. During this video I have learned that there are minor population, that they are really big population. For example, Muslim people are more or less 1 million of people, and that's too much because in Spain we are 47 million and we have to adapt education to every person in the country. I mean, no one must be outside of the education.